The Premier's problems continue today with one dumped minister breaking ranks to push for suburban stadium funding and another barred from state parliament altogether. John Sidoti will no longer be allowed inside the building, lashing out at the corruption watchdog for its report against him.
With a corruption finding against him,
it's all good, mate.
Politics has become a one-way road for John Sidoti. But the former minister is going down swinging.
ICAC has robbed me of my dignity, my career, my reputation, and my future prospects. This is a disproportionate result. This Frankenstein monster is out of control and nobody is safe.
A vote today unanimous in barring the member for Drummoyne from returning to Parliament House.
The ayes have it.
A reluctant exit with comfort from fellow dumped minister Eleni Petinos, sacked last week over bullying allegations. Today she shuffled her way onto the backbench and lobbed a grenade of her own at the Premier.
Honour the commitment to fund suburban stadiums and prevent the loss of the NRL Grand Final.
Dominic Perrottet was trying to reset, emerging with a newly elected Deputy Liberal leader.
And Matt Cain will serve a great role here.
But again, found himself fielding questions over the John Barilaro job saga, which cost Stuart Ayres his seat at the Cabinet table.
The process was flawed. I think the whole situation has been incredibly disappointing.
The Premier still has to face another 2 days of questions in Parliament, and Labor is promising to continue piling on the pressure.
But loyal foot soldiers believe there's light at the end of the tunnel.
We just need to get through the current issues.
Liz Daniels, Nine News.